We hit the go button again. We got our 30 cal dice, the 8mm we got last time. The hole inside here was not in line with the body. But what is the principle of a seating die? We are going to use our Finnish reamer to cut a seating die. This is Lee dice, and this is a 6.5 by 55. Usually, the regular die, you come in here with the case and it bottoms out. And it bottoms out before the die itself hit the shell plate. It's more than 3.5mm between here. So what actually is stopping is not the bullet hitting because I have a bullet in it. No, inside there is a bevel here. And that is what is used to crimp, or can be used to crimp, the case into the bullet if you have a cannulure in the bullet. That's a stopping point in here. This is a Lee dead center, dead length center die. See what happens. You can push it, and you can push it way into the case. There is nothing like this inside, so you can't crimp the bullet in place. But this die is meant to bottom out in the shell holder and line everything up. If we screw this out, yeah, everything's out, and do like this, just drop this one down the hole and see. And it's a little slop here. So, but that's okay. You press the die against the shell holder and the seater plug here comes down, seater bullet. The case is standing like this. It should be in line. It's a very good seater. It's a good design, simple design, good design. But this time, if I'm going to use to make something like this, I have to bore myself out here so I get a longer neck to do that. If I wasn't in a hurry, I would do that, bore it out. But today you won't get a dead length seater, you would get something similar to this. But it will function. Let's take the other shot in a moment. There is a lot of ways to skin a cat. And one of these ways can be like this. I supposed to have an 8mm bussing, but since this is a 30 cal die, I found this one. 2996 fits nicely into the hole if I do my part. It's a snug fitting bussing. It will go in and it will turn around, and that's a good thing. If you chamber a rifle, it has to turn inside the barrel. It also turns here, but it must be able to turn here. But I can't push it all the way through. It stops around here. It's a little cone here, the hole. So I will change over to a ending with 4 bussing. There is 2 or more ways to do this. I have to go back and forth. Since this bussing is less than 8mm, it's a 30 cal, we have to make sure that the cutting edge in front here is below the surface of the bussing. Otherwise it can't cut because it's not 45 degree or something angle down. There's no cutting angle at the end. But these flutes are buried below the bussing, so we can use a 30 cal bussing to make an 8 cal die. That's okay, so we can use that one. We can push the reamer with no nut, so I have to dig out my bussing again. We can do like this, and in a regular way we can run the reamer in, or we can run the reamer in approximately to the neck, and we have a dead center here, we can set up our lathe with a clock, and I can follow the slope or the TPI of the cutting edge of the flutes, and I can indicate my boring bar top slide after that. And then I can bore out the hole and go in and bore this with the same TPI I transferred from here to the lathe, and bore most of the die out, and then go in with the reamer. You save wear and tear on the reamer. If I was to make a dead length seater die, I would have bored out the die in this manner and squared it off here. Then I know for sure that this line is 90 degrees to this flat. So when I'm going to press the case and this buttons are against the shell holder, we are in line. So it's sunshine outside. I want to go home. Should I bore it with a should I ream it just with a reamer, or should I bore out the hole? I have to decide. But we have to start. We can't use all day for this shit. And here is different kind of 30 cal bearings. I don't know if you can see, but here it's a straight section. It's 0.0005 over bullet diameter. So that one I ain't going to bore away. I'm going to back bore my die until here. So this portion of the die will line the bullet up within 0.0005 to the case. There is slope here, so it's not that correct, but it will line it up. It's referenced out of here, so it's okay. It will line the bullet up very good. If I was, I've done that before, just run the reamer in like this with that 1.30 degree angle, 1.5 degree, and just run the reamer in to here, and then seat the bullet with the use of the throat. It will be very, very straight, but then you need a seater die to push the bullet further into the case. Another time may do it, but no, it's almost summer and I don't do that. So what I'm going to do, run this in and lock it with a nut with the aid of my life center. Then I will indicate here and see if it runs through, turn it down to 19.5 so I can be able to stick it into the hole. I can take this one out, indicate both the ends of the die, and turn the outside diameter of my tool, put it into the lathe again, blah, 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 blah. We ain't going to do that today. Okay, we've indicated it in. It's 0.001. It's 1/100 of a millimeter. That's okay. Let's see if we take away the live center. It's approximately 300ths, and that's fair enough for us. Taking the last pass on the OD of the die. So this is what it's going to be. And let's say the hole is 0.03, 300ths of a millimeter. We can live with that. If for any reason you have to calculate your bullet in relation to the throat, and if you have a reamer with a known free bore and lead, meaning the throat, you can take a barrel stub and run the reamer in up to the neck, including the 45er in up front. Then take the bullet, seat it in the stub, measure from here to here, and you have how far it sticks into the case, like so. Then you order your new reamer with the exact free bore you want for your new reamer, or short throat it and buy you an external throater. This is just a side note. Advice, reamers are sharp. I'm up to the neck. Looking like this, it will come out good. I told you that this seating die I'm making you will be able to crimp the bullet in place. That is not true, because that point up in the neck and the shoulder will hit the same time, so you will press your shoulder back if you try to do that. So forget about that. You can't crimp bullets, but that doesn't matter. We just started with a live center. I'm going to change to a floating reamer holder. Ain't going to see any difference, but we'll do it. We ream only a millimeter at a time before we clean it, and that's because we are going to save this one. It's a 30 hole and an 8 millimeter reamer. This is a floating type of thing. It came with a jack-up chuck, so I made this to fit a reamer inside. Easier for me. The gauge sticks out 34 millimeters. And I want to have it 4 millimeters out of the die, so it makes me 30 millimeters to go, and that is approximately 30 cleanings. Why 4 millimeter out with the gauge? A shell holder is usually 3.3 around or 3.5 deep, so if I go 4 millimeter out, the end of the die ain't going to hit the shell holder, and I have a little play up where the neck is. The gauge is sticking 8.5 millimeter out, so we go another 4 millimeters, take a check, then run it a little deep and square this surface off. The gauge is now 3.5 millimeter out, so now I take this little sucker out and I cut this surface and bevel the entrance a little bit, and we're finished on this side and I go home for the day. We try a one-hand operation and we're turning outwards. There we go. Now it's ready. Look approximately like this. And the gauge is 4 millimeter out. So this is it for today. It comes out decent. So next step is flip it around and make the bullet seating stem. And everything else is going to be in here. But no, it's warm, sun is shining, I go home. I went blank for a moment, but not anymore. When I started to talk about seaters, I was not correct, so I have to redo it. I should have deleted the first part, then start over, but I don't do that. What you do, you do. Okay. I told you, I have to find my parts. This is a regular seater. There is most of the time airspace between the end of the die and the shell holder, so you can crimp the end of the neck into a cannelure in the bullet if you wish so, or you can back the die a little out and don't do that. What is actually doing the crimping is this bevel or chamfer. This happens to be a chamfer because it's 45 degree. So if someone tell you to chamfer something, set the compound at 45 degrees. A bevel is any angle. But when the case come up here and you wish to crimp, this is the point that crimps. It forces the end of the neck down into the cannulure in the bullet. But I am using a finisher die used to chamber barrels, for example, to make a seater. Therefore, I can't crimp my bullet in place. A finish reamer is a little longer than the neck, because the case has to have some room to grow. So you can't crimp. The shoulder will hit the first. So you can't, you can make yourself a regular seater, but you can't crimp. I am told you I'm going to make you a regular seater, but I ain't. I did something that was wrong. Let's say the shell holder takes up 3.5 millimeter, it doesn't, but approximately, before the end of the die hits. And I was shooting for 4 millimeters. What happens then? Yes, the shoulder will hit the first, if I wish to. So I was basically making an FL, a full length sizer die with a finish reamer, but it doesn't matter. The original one is like that, so you can actually push the neck into the bullet, but not the shoulder. This die, that's a dead length seater from Lee. You could push the case quite a ways in there. And we don't talk more about that because we started with that. But what I'm going to do is not, as I talked about when I made it, have it 4 millimeters out. So I have to set it up again and I have to run the reamer a little deeper. So let's say I shoot for 2.5 millimeter out here. Then I have 0.08 or 1 millimeter to 1.5 millimeter, depends on whoever going to chamber the barrel will do. So I'm going to run it deeper and make you a dead length seater. I was on the right track, but it was the wrong train. Shit happens, but that's, you know, I'm not that bright, but I'll try. New day and new possibilities. One of them goes like this. I talked about the 4 millimeter out with my gauge. I would make it 2.5 millimeter out. Then I changed my mind and says I go a little deeper, and that happened to be 1.8 millimeter. That's not just a number, it's not for a particular reason. So if we measure this with a clock or a depth gauge, it will read 1.8. That's because the die will hit the shell holder and we are dead sure it's play up to the neck. So you can't run it up to the neck. That's part of why I did it. Another thing is, this is a seater die for 8x61 Norwegian S. The parent case is 93x62. And if you have new cases, there is no problem. They are smaller, the outer dimension on the case, but this one has been shot in a 9362 chamber, so it's a used case I picked up from the range, or wherever I got it, don't remember. Let's say the range. The resize reamer that was made, it's just pressed the body of the case, the minimal amount. I'm going to show you the drawings of the 9362 and the Norwegian thing at another time. But when I was finished with the die seater and the gauge was sticking 4 millimeter out, I tried to push this case into the gauge and see it rubs here when it put you in the, when I put you in the seater. And I know I'm reamed this with a finisher reamer. So what actually happens. When I press the case with the resizer that was made, it press it back and it's it press it in and it springs a little back. And since it was much larger here to begin with, it springs back too much, so it rubs inside here. So when I deepen it, it will cure the problem. That's a good thing. And this one is tied. Let's see what happened. Runs in with no problem. And I have to change my hands. I should have been an octopus. That has been fun. One hand up the back and, you know, the other. Yeah. Good. No rubbing. Turns freely. Everyone is happy. If I didn't tell you, you wouldn't know. But I like to talk for some reason. So we're finished for today. So we'll try to flip it around and take the other end another day. Yeah, when I talked about the case that rubbed inside the sitter die, that is reamed with a finisher reamer. And a case shot in a regular 9362 chamber before I pressed it down with the FL die I made with the interchangeable buzzing. So it springs back. That's what it why it rubs. I have to squeeze it so much down. This is the print for the 8x61 Norwegian S. The finished reamer print. Here is the measurement for the resize reamer. So it only pressed the case, the resize reamer, back approximately 0.0035 inches. That's a minimum. And that is approximately 0.089 or 0.09 millimeters. So it's under a tenth of a millimeter. So when we used cases that has been shot in another chamber, we get a problem. I'm gonna solve that later on. And new cases, they are manufactured to minimum specifications, so they will fit nicely if you use new cases. So I got a resize reamer and a standard resize reamer that press the body down, but not the neck. That is per drawing. But the reamer I wished to have made me a neck for 3346, and that's approximately, if I remember correct, 8.49 millimeters, and the finisher is 899. You can arrest me on that one because you can add all this up, but I think it's like that. So the resizer that will come in the mail, squeeze the neck down, and I've done something that's not normal. It says 2520 long cut. That means the neck is longer. So you must never ever use that resizer as a refer when you chamber a barrel and run it in with the go gauge and just go a little back. You have to take into account that the neck is longer, otherwise you're in deep shit. So, and we can take the print, if you remember, 4457. Here is the measurement for 9362 case, and we see it's 452, and this is a minimum specification reamer print. So in real life, production wise, production guns usually larger up here. And in the back, this is 4764, and that is 4793. But that is in the back. This is 200s further to the shoulder. And you have also something called USA match. That's nothing more than the base It's a little bit smaller, so you can call it 9362 small base, because you can use odd 6 cases also. So that's the print type of thing. Here we go again. I have to make an arrangement so I can seat the bullets. I can't seat the 8mm bull down a 30 cal hole, so I have to do something. And what? I have to think about that for a moment. Okay. This for a 6.5 55. OAL is 84mm. This one is 98. If I deduct those two, I get 7mm, so I have to cut you 7mm down. And why 91? It's because 6.5 55 to 61 length, that's 6mm, plus 1 just to add something more, that's the 91 figure. And the reamer, when it was run up the die, from the end of the die to the neck before the chamfer, 59.6. And the freebore section is approximately 5.1mm. And that makes me, and I don't want the 5.1. I cut it a little back so I have some thing I can err on both sides here, mostly on this side. So I say I want this section 4. So it will be the length I run the reamer in plus 4. That is 63.9. And if I calculate right when I cut it, so it ends up 91, deduct that measurement, then I know I have to backbore me down here 27.4. Then I end up exactly, I think, here. That's what we are going to do now, and I'm going to thread it. I have to find out what kind of threads I'm going to use, because I'm going to make, if I can, this one and the seater stem. So we'll talk about that another day. So we have to go to work. Why do I want this section 4mm freebore? Say that. This die, dead length seater from Lee for 6.5 55, there is next to nothing. It's backboard up to here someplace. And it's a floating thing, so this floats inside here. Press it up, floats a little, line the bullet up. So I could have done the same, but I wish to try, because this section will steer my bullet straight in relation to the case. We have to see if we make a difference when we try the runout gauge on the finished cartridge, but I do it anyways. One problem I can run into is like this. If you flip this around or turn it, maybe, is the bullet, and this come down here and try to seat it. I may run the seater stem down and touch here, and I can't seat my bullet as far down as I wish to. But that's a calculated risk. It's no big deal to correct it, but I wish to try this one, see if it can work. And the runout is 0.04 and a half millimeters, and the runout on the outside of the die body is 0.01mm, so it's much less. And the die is made, the outside first with the threads and everything, then they are bored the hole, so I gambled it's the hole, but I don't care about that. We use it as is. We are going to cut it at 27 and we are going to turn the rest of it, but we have to have ourselves a reference point that comes right now. Here we can hear it touching, and I'm going to have this section, so I have to indicate this side of the cutoff tool. When you screw it up, you take the other side, and you have 3 millimeters on the wrong side. Yeah, I said we're going 27.4 this way. Huh. Think if I do that. That's inside. The length of the die is going to be cut down with 7 millimeters. So I cut it off on 6.5. And you can't cut it off and use a live center or a dead center. The parts will break down like this, lock the tool and break it. So this is just to stiffen up things before I come all the way through. So you have to go in here a little bit this way in, so we get a little free space, but I'll see if I can do it with one hand. Now I have a reference surface for my cutter. I go a little bit this way. And you can see you load up the tool, but for now that is good. And now we're coming. How far can I go before the shit hits the fan? I don't want to load up the tool. I can try to add a few RPMs. Maybe in the 1000 range. We did it at 500. And we lose some of our new die. And now we are going to find where it touches, approximately here. And I'm going to set my dials. Okay, we have done that. Lock this one down. And then we go in with a cut. Like that. Go a little ways this way. Take a little bit. Go in again, take the last one, so we go to 5 exactly, and we hit the go button. So when this cut is done, it's 0.5 millimeter, 0.5. Yes, and I did take a measurement from here to the old length, so I'm going to check to see if I'm close. If it looks right, it's right. Nothing have moved, so we are ready to move on. We're shooting for a depth of 27.4. The tip here lines up approximately here, and we are going to look or watch this dials and use our hand crank. So let's see what we can do. This is just roughing. if I was smart, I will withdraw it and see my progress by eye. But I ain't that smart. So if I suddenly start screaming, you know why. And we are going 20 millimeters. Am I chickening out? Maybe, okay. To come back to the right spot again, we can use this carrier as a reference. And we can take a peek. Yeah, it tells me it's a little more to go. Approximately there. And we have something to work on, the 4 millimeter thing. So it ain't that bad. And we have 25, 26, and let's say 27. And we can blow you. We can look at you after you are blown. And I think it's okay. Ended up with a 12.5 drill bit and went in like so, and it's tired in the end. So I know with my dial so far I can go in and I can see. So it's ready to meet the boring ball. And we are digging into the hole. That's a good thing. And we have to look at the dials like that. Almost at the end. So we are approximately 26 deep and 14.4 wide. ID. It's squared off from the center out, and now I'm backing it out for approximately 14.5 millimeter ID. And when that is done, almost ready for threading. We can take a peek down the hole. I tried to push a bullet through, and that is possible. Tight fit and good fit. So this is a little counter bore down here. I don't like my threads sticking all the way up. I'm bored today, lazy. I don't want to single point cut it today, so it will never be. So we use a tap. Run it down. This is a M16 by 1.5. I should have had by 1, but I couldn't find it. But this threads is approximately the same as the Lee one, but finer thread is better for adjustment. But it's not mine, it's yours. You get it. This one has been in the hole. No, it's the plug tap. This is approximately 0.4 millimeter less diameter than this one. So it will turn out good, I think. No, we are right here. And I'm going to knurl it on the outside, finish it off, and say goodbye for today. Yeah, here it is. This comes out decent. This comes out like piece of shit. Why does it go like this down here, up again? Doesn't look nice. This is the best I could do when disaster hit me. And, you know, not a first-class machinist. In the lower grades, I think this little screw wasn't in here, or bolt. This loosened up and it turned the knurling tool this way, and you know, I wasn't satisfied with what it looked like. So this is nothing for the eye, that's for sure. But I can go home and cry, one solution, drink a beer, another solution, give a shit, the third solution. I take third solution. What I can do, I can start all over. Best thing, I can turn this a little down, thread it, screw another unit on here, Loctite it in place, or it can just be like that, screwed on, meter shoulder, bore it, start all over again from this end. And it'll be a little fatter here, it will look very cool. But I don't do it, and otherwise, this section is thin, very thin. Remember, don't drop it to the floor, because then you ruin this expensive part, and that is not my fault. Comprende? So, I leave the scene, come back another day. I've calculated some of the measurements to make a bullet seater. This is for the 6.5, and it's an 8mm bullet, 308 bussing. Try to use the throat on the reamer and make something like this, if possible. Easiest way would have been just to turn yourself in here, but I try to do it the hard way, see if it works. Experiment. Run this throat into this hole, see what happens. The reamer made this one. Probably a couple of hours go down the drain and I have to start over. I've never used the throat of a reamer before. I've just late bored myself a hole with a cone. It may work. I have done some measurements. Pull it in here. Die here to the bottom of the stem runs out in the bottom of the die. And I measured from the end of the bullet to the end of the die. So I know what that measurement is. But what I have to do, and this one drops through. This is 62.5 long or something, so I have to cut it to 61 because the neck is bottoming out in the die. And then I have to have a handful of different bullets and do a test. I've done some calculations regarding the bullet seating stem, how to finish that off. It's correct for me, so I have just to cut it off at the right length. I have to think about that. But I've done some calculations with 220 Sierra Game King, 200 Akubond Nochler, 170 grain spear, some bullets, I think 196 cellular bellot, but I don't remember. And I've used the shell holder, the case, measured back and forth, calculated. And this is how far the bullet will be sticking down the case from the mold down to the down the case. That's good, that's good. That is not good, only 5 millimeters approximately, or a little bit less, because this is maximum when the bullet stem is screwed way down the die and we want it to float a little, so we have to back it off. And that is acceptable. So the spare one, there will not be a very good grip on the bullet. Then I had to remachine the seating stem a little bit to seat this bullet a little further down, and it will then work with everything else. But I'm lazy today, I don't want to do that. But what will the overall length of the case be then? So I've tried to measure and calculate, and I came to the conclusion that maximum 83, 84, 81, 83.8. When the bullet sits in the case. So that's just a number, but we have to think about the magazine. What is the length of the magazine? In this case, it's going to live in a M98 old Mercer, and those ones approximately 84, and you can modify it 85 and a half. Let's say you have approximately 86 millimeter magazine length and seat the bullet, so you have a little free play, 85 85 and a half. That means you're all set with this one. So what I have to do now is to calculate the outer length of the seating stem in relation to my, let's call it a seater plug. When I screw up and down, I want to be able to have a shoulder here, so when I screw the seater plug, if you can call it that, it's not the correct name, but down, there will be a little float in the bullet seating stem. I don't want you to be able to screw it down so you lock it inside the die and it won't float. Because if you want to seat the bullet further down, that's possible, that's exactly what you're going to do. And you realize it at another time. So, this is what I'm going to do. Okay, now we're cutting it off at approximately 34.5, 34.6. My cutter is dull or not on the correct position, correct. I can see that by the cut. But okay, we don't care. And off we come. Voila. Today it's hot. So, I have to eat my ice cream. But, bullet seating stem, finished. It's a rather big hole, and it goes in here. So, three of the bullets you can see it, but it could have been shortened a bit up, so it rides further out here. That would be the best thing, but that's what I did. Usually the hole in the middle is smaller and the seating stem hits up here someplace. Then you have a wide range to adjust the bullet. But what may happen when you do it like that? Not with the lead bullets, but if you have a competition bullet, a hollow point, it's very thin here. And when your die touches here, your seater, it makes a ring. It actually squeezes the bullet a little bit in while it tries to seat it. And that irritates me. So then I make my own bullet stem and open up the hole a little bit. I may make you another one, just a small hole with a little cone in so you can seat whatever bullet you need, but for now, this is it. Starting on the seater plug or bolt or whatever, but I just rough turn this and make me a shoulder. So I flip it around, I can't push it back while machining, and if it's for some reason I take it out, I will come fairly close to zero, better than with this raw material. Only reason. And I make the center hole while it's hanging out here. A lot of the times you have it just a couple of centimeters out of the chuck and then make a center hole. And when you drag it out to approximately here, the center will wobble. No good thing. This won't wobble. Here's the cap for the lead eye. It ain't much threads, it's short. So I think it's because you have the threads and it can float a little bit like this and line up the top where the bullet seating stem is trying to line up. I think that's the idea. That O-ring, I think, I haven't taken this away and tried without, is for, you're gonna have a little resistance into this piece if you have an O-ring. Otherwise, it comes out of adjustment easily. This is just a guess, I guess. Here is what I made. I made a groove for the O-ring. And the die, it's 28 something down to the bottom. This is 27, so this will button out, not that one. And I think that will work. We're going to, I have more threads because I think it wiggles anyways. We're gonna see. First of all, is it still in line? Yes. The hole in the middle isn't moving much, meaning we haven't bent the piece while we were machining. Lucky again. Meet up with the die. Screw it all the way to the bottom, little up, and it wiggles. But it comes easily out of adjustment. Next to nothing. Okay, we'll try it with the O-ring. Where's the O-ring? Will I be able to put it on? Yes. Do I need to deepen the groove? Or am I able to screw it on? Yes, I'm able to screw it on with a lot of resistance. Meaning, I need another O-ring, smaller one. I've threaded it up to the shoulder, back it a little off. Can I wiggle it? Yes, I can. I changed the O-ring. Am I able to get this one off? And no, you can't accidentally touch the bullet seating stem arrangement and get it out of adjustment. It was just a smaller O-ring, and that rests down there right now. But anyways, that's what you get. I can't deepen this groove anymore, so you have to live with it, even if you don't wish to. Get yourself a new O-ring. So I go home to 4 children, 2 dogs, a cat, and the old lady, and we go for a swim. I didn't like the way the O-ring left me and came out there, so I took something like this. It's curved this way, so the O-ring will have a difficult time trying to roll over and out. And if it works, this time I've tried it, so I don't bother screw it all the way in, but I can screw it in with resistance, and I can screw it out, and there is no ring. Lucky again. Not lucky. Now I have to run a drill bit in, let turn myself like this and out again, approximately 10 millimeter hole. Yeah, we're on the way in. With an 8.5 millimeter. To make this one to float when the die button's out, I have a little reference. Now I am 3 something maybe out. From here to the bottom, 28.5. Here to bottom, 27. So if this sticks out 1.5, I'm close. You have to start checking. Here we can see a little bit over 1 millimeter to go. And then we have to float it. If I can drag this one out and look down the hole. Now I have contact with the shoulder, I think, so it better float. The question is, by how much?
today's last cut home and try if it's seat bullets. And I'm not left-handed, so this was a bad approach. Okay, good enough.
Screwed all the way to the bottom. It rattles it inside. This is a familiar thing, but by how much? Okay, we are over to the bullet seating stem. I shortened the die a little bit up and took a little bit here, played for the back and forth. So approximately I have a half millimeter free float down here. I think it was a little bit too much. I had 08 or 09 the first time, so I just shortened things up. So, you know, and then sell it on a lot. 196 will be this far down the neck with this old stem. Okay, with this 220 Sierra and the old bullet seating stem, you can seat it. That one you can't. I make you a new stem. This grabs the bullet way down. So if I can get my fingers working, it's too late on a Saturday evening, we can try a 3 auto thing. We can try 280 AI 6.8 SPC. What kind of animal is this? 6.5 odd 6 Blastel, made by the famous reamer maker Elliot. That's actually a 6.5 06, shorted a little bit down, with a sharper shoulder. But what are we going to talk about? 7.2 millimeter. We end up where? I'm not left-handed, so let's say 7 millimeters. We end up there instead of there. Okay, we go for a 7 millimeter. Why don't I bore a hole and cone it? Very easy. No. I ream it with that one.
Now it's ready to meet the first drill bit. This is going to be the 7 millimeter thing. 1 millimeter, the 10 millimeters in. 15, 20, aggressive, 25, is that approximately, probably. Do you think this buzzing has a close fit in the hole? Look at this one, drags it back. We have ourselves an hydraulic cylinder. Okay, and it buttons out at 25 millimeters, so I ain't going to be able to run it any deeper. And we see what's going to happen. And we end up with something like this. It didn't sharpen up, but okay, it doesn't matter. And let's say 220 bullet. We grab it up here, is that good? Can we seat it way down the case? Yes. This one, will it grab it approximately here? Yes. I have to drop it from my other hand. This is the shorty. Will it seat the shorty way down there? Yes, it will. And this one? Yes, it will. And remember, this one stem, you will be able to lock down if you wish so. So don't ever screw it so we'll lock it on the in the bottom of the die, because then it can't float. Okay? I'm gonna give you a little cone angle, let's say 25, just a number, so you don't have this very, very, very sharp angle. I can't polish it away, but we'll take it this way. Now we see where we're at. Does it take anything? No. back the wheel out a little bit, in a little bit. No, this is just trial and error. Start to take a bite, maybe. No. Yes, a little more. Yes. The angle is broken. We're gonna polish a little bit.
I told you that this one, you can't screw all the way down because it will bottom out. No, it won't. It will float forever if you wish so. But then you have run your bullet way too far down the neck. Okay, but we take a short process and let it fall to the ground. There is some religion that say there is something that's not going to fall to the ground. Guess what that is? Is this not set up right? Shit, I have to saw it off or set it on center or something. How could that happen? With me? Hush, strange.
But who cares? I'm a strong man.
Ooh, ho ho. The world's greatest.
Okay, here it is. Will it float? No. Probably. You can't bottom out the old stem, new stem. It will float. You can see the bullet way down there. You are a happy guy.
And here you see the difference. Two different holes. Same outside, different inside.